I must warn that this video is strictly for married women. Common mistake women make when it comes to sex. Exploring and experiencing intimacy can be done in different ways. And this is one experience that should be highly enjoyable by the both partners. But in case you have not been enjoying your sexual relationship and you want to work on it, stick with me as I explain some powerful points on how you can improve on your sex life. First mistake, getting stuck in monotonous pattern in your bedroom. Some women do it intentionally because they feel that other sexual patterns and styles are not Christian. They feel missionary style is the only style that a Christian partner should explore when it comes to sex. But my dear, that is a very wrong assumption. As long as God has created this institution and made it for your own enjoyment, relax when it comes to such activity. Relax and go along with your partner and explore as many positions as possible. Feel free, free your mind. Yes, because I have seen women ask me, I don't think this style is favorable for a married woman. Why should a husband ask his wife to have a doggy style with her? Like, questions like that should not come up. As long as these things are being done the right way, position doesn't count. It shouldn't matter, because all these things will bore your partner. And sometimes, out of anger, some partners can start to practice infidelity, because some of us limit them to only one way of expressing sexual experience, which is not equally good for you. It's good that every woman relax and enjoy any style your partner had to bring to the table that is safe for you. Mistake number two, worrying too much about your physical appearance. This can be very, very worrisome, especially to women who are now giving birth. You know, I equally experienced it, because after having a child, some of us come up with fat on our abdominal area, stretch marks, and what have you. Sometimes hyperpigmentation, darkening around your neck, darkening around your stomach, and you feel so insecure when you look back on what your body used to be and how it is at that moment after having your child. You feel so insecure and unattractive. But hey, that shouldn't be a concern. Men don't really put that at the back of their mind. They know what you have been through and they appreciate you for having their child. And for that reason, I don't see the reason why any woman shouldn't relax and experience intimacy with her partner just because you have some, you acquired stretch marks after having a child, or some baby bump that has not really gone back to the way it used to be. It shouldn't be so much concern. Sometimes women find it difficult to really come up on the man because they feel the man will pay attention to their saggy stomach and all those stretch marks. If you don't bother looking at how your husband looks when you are having sex, why do you think your husband will bother about it when you are having sex with him? So I think every woman should be proud of what she has been through. You have gone through this 9 months pregnancy, gone to labor ward, come out alive, your husband is happy, you are happy. I think you should be take it easy on yourself and loosen up. Do not mind about how you look. If your husband is not complaining, why should you complain? Relax and enjoy your sexual intimacy. Mistake number three, not communicating your sexual preference. Yes, this is one of the major errors women make when it comes to sex and all the experience that had to do with it. Just the way it has been emphasized that communication is very important in marriage, it boils down to sex. You should be able to let your partner understand the kind of sexual preference you have so that they can help you in achieving a very beautiful sexual experience? What is the need of having sex if you don't enjoy it? What is the need of going down with intimate experience if you can't be free to tell your partner that I don't like this thing to be done this way, that I could have preferred it this way? If you don't tell them, they will not help you. So it is better for every woman to be bold enough to discuss sexual issues, preference, with her husband, so that he will know what to change. See, these guys are always ready and willing to help you achieve orgasm when it comes to sex. So just loosen up, feel free. You can initiate a way of communicating it with him. If you are too shy, you can send him a chat about what you feel or what you want him to be doing. He can confront you with it, and then before you know it, your problem is solved. So please do not die in silence if the way he handles things are not the way you want them to be handled, or if you feel there are things you want to do and he is not yet doing it. Tell it. Open up. Let him know. He is not God, and for that reason, he cannot be in your mind to know what you want and what you don't want. Communication is key to a successful relationship. Mistake number 4, do not smash his ego. Sometimes, this man might not know exactly what you want, or maybe they did something and they didn't get it right. Even after you have communicated to them about your preference, instead of you to smash their ego alongside, you should find a way of letting him know that, I wish you did this way. If you had done it this way, I feel it could have been better. Their ego is very important to them. So if you smash it along the line, a message you are planning to pass across might not be gotten at the end of the day, and the both of you will not end up well when it comes to matters like this. Mistake number 5, hygiene. Hygiene is very, very crucial for both male and female when it comes to sex. There are people who feel that hygiene is just by clean shaving their pubic area and armpits. Yes, it could be part of it, but that's is not the only thing hygiene covers when it comes to sex. Some men in particular don't like their women to shave completely. They want that place trimmed a little bit. So learn to trim your pubic area very well. It doesn't have to look like a bush or forest. Trim it and wash it well. You don't have to insert anything. See, you maintain proper hygiene by just washing your pubic area. Do not allow anybody to introduce you into inserting all manner of things for vaginal tightening. Those things can actually cause fungal infection and some other issues, and equally give you a vaginal odor. Then it can subsequently lead to something else. So women should avoid inserting things into their vagina. Shave your armpit. Clean shave on your armpit. Make sure you smell nice. Apply deodorant on your armpit. Brush at least twice daily, before and after bedtime. Have your bath twice, at least twice a day. It's equally very important that you keep your environment clean. Yes. Untidy and unclean environment can be a put-off for some men. There are women who use a bedspread for more than 1 month. You find all manner of things on their bed. When they want to go to bed, they shift things, they move things away just to lie down. That is not right. Some men will come back home with diapers littered all over the place. Plates you use for eating littered around the house. Some might not be washed, might have been there for more than 3 days. All these things can actually be a put-off for your men. Some women complain, my husband don't make love to me. He does not have sex with me. If I ask him, he will say he will give some trivial excuses. Yes, maybe the man just doesn't want to hurt you. But please, women, if you want your husband to always be in the mood, make sure your environment is clean and homely for him whenever he comes home. If you are busy that you cannot do all that by yourself, get a helping hand. Get a helping hand, depending on the country where you are. Get a helping hand. In Nigeria, we can easily employ nannies to tidy up our houses, wash our clothing and all that, then try to dress neatly, wear clean dress. There are women that repeat one particular dress for 1 week. You wear this dress to bed, you sweat on it, the next day you repeat it, it smells. Make sure your dress are always clean and dress well to suit the occasion. Some women wear outdoor wears to bed. That is not right. If you feel the weather is so cold that you cannot wear sexy revealing lingerie, get a sleeping suit that will give you a very beautiful figure. That will go a long way. Do not wear the things you wear to church back to your bed. Some women don't wash their hair. Keep your hair clean and let it smell nice. Some of us tie our turban to bed because we will pray in the midnight. Hey, please, take it easy on yourself. Loosen up. God is not as religious as we women used to think he is. God created this institution and we should loosen up to enjoy the full potential of sex and all the experiences it has to offer. Mistake number 6, failure to initiate sex by women. In the course of my experience in life as a therapist, one common complaint married men give is that their wives do not initiate sex and they get tired of initiating sex all the time. In fact, there are couples who stayed almost a year without having sexual experience just because the man got tired and he felt like, this woman doesn't need me after all, let me just relax. Whenever she needs me, let her come. I'm tired of chasing her. Sometimes women have to be begged and all that. Yes, maybe you will say, it's not easy for me to take care of the kids, clean the house, do all that, go to work and all that. You feel the work is so cumbersome that you get tired in the night. But hey, there are ways to get all these things done without you necessarily being too tired. And then please do not be shy. Some women feel if they open up to their men about their sexual desire, that the men will tell them they are prostitutes or think. It's usually assumption, actually. We assume too much that our men will feel we are loose whenever we ask for sex. But it is not that way. Men feel happy when their women ask for sex, and it makes them feel wanted. It gives them a very good sense of belonging. So please, women, do not always wait for these men to come begging for sex. Ask them once in a while. If you feel like having this experience, tell him. Every couple should have their love language, a way they communicate their sexual desire, either by action or by verbal communication. Let your spouse know that you are interested in this tonight or whenever you feel like having it. You can equally organize a getaway, a romantic getaway. These are the things you do to spice up your marriage. Marriage is beautiful. Marriage is sweet. And when sex is not being fulfilled, you find out that there is usually some unnecessary friction in the home. You can quarrel for nothing, actually, when you don't have a fulfilled sexual desire. You can fight for nothing. You can have unnecessary and trivial arguments just because this part of your relationship is not being met. And it is very, very crucial. It is a way of exercising your body, a way of exercising your heart. It is one thing you do to keep your day moving. It makes you excited. It makes you feel like someone needs you. It makes you feel wanted, both the male and woman. So let's not complicate our matters by playing too much religiosity when it comes to having sexual intercourse with our husbands. We are Christians. We love God, and it's God that created this, and we should all relax and enjoy it to the fullest. If you are coming across my channel for the first time and you so enjoyed this topic, if you have concern and more questions to ask on this particular subject matter, do not forget to drop a comment and I will be there to answer you.